thank you very much. Before I tell you about the Schubert Arpeggione Sonata, I would like to introduce my colleague Eric Wong. And if you would like to know more about Eric, you can read his very impressive bio on my website. So now about the Schubert Arpeggione Sonata. The Arpeggione was an instrument that was developed 1823, something like that. And it had popularity for about 10 years, and then it kind of disappeared. Schubert wrote this beautiful sonata for it in 1824, but it wasn't published until 50 years later, which is ironic because 50 years later, Schubert had passed away and the Arpeggione was no longer used at all. So if you don't know what it is, you're not alone, because I've never seen one either. It looks like a big guitar. It has six strings, frets, but the difference is it has a bridge. And this is a bridge, for those of you who don't know. And a bridge holds up the strings. Because the strings are held up, you can't play this instrument like you do a guitar like this. So you use a bow, and you sit, and remember, it's a big guitar, so it has to be held between the knees, and you bow it. I think there are about maybe five or six in existence today. Some are in museums, and some are in musicologists' homes or offices, people that specialize in interesting instruments. The music was published, since there was no more arpeggione, violists and cellists have taken it upon themselves to keep alive this gorgeous sonata, so you will hear it in their performances. Our next piece that we'll play for you is the Hindemith Sonata for Viola and Piano, Opus 11, number 4. And this is in three movements: fantasy, theme with variations, and there's a finale. And in parentheses in the music, it says with variations. And that's because the variations are borrowed from the tune in the second movement, and he also has a new tune in the last movement. Now, without going into this whole sonata, I just want to explain to my listeners, if they're not familiar with the musical term variation. In music, a variation is a tune that we decorate. So for example, if you have a doll and you have different wigs and different makeup and different lipstick and different clothes, you can keep changing, right? And you can make it into a disguise. There's still the same doll that's a little recognizable, but sometimes you don't recognize it at all, maybe just a little bit. So this is what Hindemith has done with these variations. I hope that your job as a listener, I'm giving you a job. Your job is to say, aha, if you recognize part of a tune, say it to yourself. But the main job is to check in with yourself when it's all over, to see if this music has transported you to a different place, to a different dimension, that doesn't have politics, that doesn't have war or disease. As a matter of fact, I have something that I would like to read to you that Hindemith wrote. Now, Hindemith was in World War I, and his officer asked him to form a string quartet to entertain the officers and troops on the front line. So they did. And during a performance, they were playing the Debussy String Quartet. News reached the front that Debussy had just passed away. This was very traumatic because they were playing the Debussy String Quartet. Plus, Hindemith loved Debussy's music. So he wrote in his journal, "We realized for the first time that music is more than style, technique, and the expression of personal feelings. Music stretched beyond political boundaries, national hatred, understood so clearly as then what direction music must take. This sonata is played without pause.